Governed under the amendment of the Aviation Act in 1989, Zambia Airports Corporation is charged with the day-to-day management, maintenance, and development of all international airports within the country. These airports include Kenneth Kaunda International Airport in Lusaka, Simon Mwantakapwepwe International Airport in Ndola, Harry Mwangang Kumbula International Airport in Livingston, and Mfuwe International Airport.
Government, through Zambia Airports Corporation Limited, has an ambitious project of upgrading and expanding the existing airport infrastructure into ultra-modern facilities. To this effect, the corporation has since spent $60 million to upgrade and build a new international passenger terminal building at Harry Mwangang Kumbula International Airport, which is near completion and is expected to be commissioned this year. Further, Kenneth Kaunda is earmarked to be transformed into a hub. To this effect, $360 million has been earmarked to see that Kenneth Kaunda is upgraded, which will include a 4 million capacity terminal building, which will house 6 aero bridges. This particular expansion will see to it that the airport is able to accommodate medium and large aircraft that are available commercially. And also, we expect to see an increase in terms of the passenger. Currently, Kenneth Kaunda is doing 1 million passengers, but we expect that in the next coming years, once the airport turns into a hub, we see that this projection will further increase. Our anticipation that in the next 5 years, we want to see that Kenneth Kaunda will be able to handle more than 2 million passengers per annum.
With its mandate, the organization has embarked on major infrastructure development projects to upgrade these airports with the aim of enabling better passenger and cargo facilitation. This is the ongoing works at the Kenneth Kaunda International Airport. The first phase, which is currently underway, includes the construction of a 4 million capacity terminal building, 6 aero bridges, as well as an air traffic control tower, fire and rescue station, and a presidential terminal. These inclusions will see an increase in the number of tourists and business travelers at the airport, as well as heighten the level of safety and security for all travelers and stakeholders alike.
During the time of construction, we are urging the passengers and also workers within the airports to be patient, in that there will be a number of disruptions as this construction will be taking place. But at the end of it all, we expect excitement from the airlines, airport employees and workers, and other agents operating within our airports, in that this modern infrastructure will make us not only as airports, but all individuals working within the airports to be happy. We expect also the airlines, who are our major clients, also to be excited and embrace the infrastructure that is coming up. The shopping mall is also an additional facility where we expect people and travelers who'll be using our airports also to spend a bit of time and also relax and enjoy the nice food that will be provided at these shopping malls that we have embarked upon.
The second phase of the expansion includes the construction of a 30-room in-transit hotel, as well as a 70-room non-transit passenger hotel. Other developments are the inclusion of a shopping mall, a new cargo terminal, and aircraft hangar. The upgrade of the airport will also see the introduction of the Smart Airport Systems, SAS, to international airports in the country. This system is an integral part of any modern airport's operations that enhances efficiency and effectiveness in the airport while providing immaculate safety and security to travelers, airlines, and airport operators. The installation of the SAS is expected to improve the passengers' experience as well as provide business intelligence that will allow Zambia Airports Corporation to make better decisions with the right information at the right time. Another project that is of great importance to the Zambia Airports Corporation is the construction of the Greenfield International Airport in Ndola, which has been allocated over $397 million.
This is a complete greenfield project to be constructed in Sichele Forest, surrounded by four towns, namely Ndola, Kitwe, Mfurila, and Luansha. And the construction contract has already been signed by Ministry of Works and Supply, and we're only waiting for the finalization of the loan agreement by Ministry of Finance. I'm saying this because this project is of interest to the Copper Belt. This project is expected to create 3,000 jobs, and this ultra-modern facility will include hotels, shopping malls, and other world-class modern facilities befitting a modern international airport.
Close to $400 million has been set aside for the rehabilitation of the Kenneth Kaunda International Airport that will see the airport rise to the standards of international airports within the region and overseas.